Hi, this is Sunil, and in this lecture, I am going to teach you how to create animations using HTML5. And in this lecture, we are going to create a circle, and then we'll try to do some animation with that circle. We'll try to move the circle from one point to another point. We'll try to fill colors in the circle and so on. So to start with, for creating HTML5 canvas animation, we need two things. We need a HTML5 and we need a JavaScript. We can create a canvas, but we can do animations only with the JavaScript. So we need to write some JavaScript as well. For that reason, I have created two files. One is index.html for our HTML web page and canvas.js, which is for canvas JavaScript. So what I do, first thing, I'll create a HTML file. So I'll create a HTML tag and then I'll close it, and then I'll create a head tag and I'll close this, and then I'll create a body tag and I'll close this. So this is simple HTML5 file, and here I'll put a h1 tag, and inside that I'll put my circle animations as heading, and I'll close this h1 tag. Okay, so test this. I'll see here, now our heading is coming. The next thing is, we need to create a canvas. So for creating a canvas, we need to use the canvas tag, and then we need to give the canvas ID, so that with this ID we can access this canvas in our JavaScript. So I'll create a canvas with ID my canvas, and I'll give a width and height for this canvas as a 300 and 300. You can give whatever you want. So I'll give 300 and 300, and then I'll give one more thing. I'll give the style for this, and style will be for bordering. Okay, so I'll give border, comma, I'll give it as 3px pixel, and then I'll give a solid, and I'll give a color as black, and then I'll close this. I'll close this canvas, and then we'll go and see here. Now our canvas is ready. So this is the canvas with the border with a black color, and this is the heading we have given. Now inside this canvas, we'll try to put some circle or rectangle, whatever we want, and then we'll be creating some animation with that. So let's start. So to create animation on the canvas, this canvas, my canvas, we need to write a JavaScript. So now I'll open this canvas.js file. You can create a JavaScript file and start writing. I'll create a function, and I'll give it a name, my circle animation. Okay, my circle animation, and I'll close it. So to test this, what I'll do, I'll put I am canvas, and I'll put here. And then to call this JavaScript in HTML, what we need to do, we need to put the script tag here. Okay, and then we have to give the type will be text/JavaScript, and then source will be canvas.js, source for the JavaScript file, and then we will be closing this script tag. And then what I do, I'll run this. Okay, I'm not calling the function, so I need to call this on onload, and onload I will be calling this function that we have written in the JavaScript, my circle animation, and I'll put here. Okay, now see here, I'm getting the alert I am canvas. It means we are calling the JavaScript file successfully. So we are getting this alert message, I am canvas, which I have written here in the JavaScript file, I am canvas. Okay, so this means we are successfully accessing the JavaScript file from the HTML. So now I'll write the JavaScript function to create a circle. So first thing we need to do is, we need to create a variable called my canvas, and in this, what I'll do, I'll be calling document.getElementById, and I'll be giving the ID as a my canvas. Okay, so what is this my canvas? This my canvas I have given here in index.html. see, my canvas. So this canvas ID I'm accessing in JavaScript, so that I can do something with that. And then next thing is, we need to get the context. So for that, I'll create a variable context, and I'll use my canvas, the variable which we have created here, this one. And what I'll do, I'll get my canvas dot get context. Okay, so and in the get context we'll be giving 2D animations, so we'll give 2D. Okay, so now we are accessing the canvas and we have the context for that canvas. So next thing is what I need to write. I need to write another function, and this function I'll give it a name, draw circle. Okay, so what I'm going to do in this draw circle, I'm going to draw a circle. So for that what I do, I'll get this context and context dot, I'll use begin path method and here. Okay, so giving the path, begin path means the point from where we'll start creating something on the canvas, and then I'll be using context dot arc. Since there is no method, direct method to create a circle, we'll be using arc method to create a circle. And arc, what it takes, it takes the initial point x and y axis. I'm giving 50 50, so x axis x coordinate 50 and y coordinate 50. And then the next thing is radius of the circle, I'll give 40, and then it will ask for the initial angle and the ending angle, and ending angle I'll give 2 into math.py. Okay, so now we are ready with the context. Next thing what I need to do, I need to context.stroke, and so now with this we can create a circle. Next thing is we need to call this method here, draw circle, and then we need to go and refresh this, click on OK. See here, now we have drawn a circle on our canvas. So this way we can draw a circle on our canvas. So what we did, we have created a canvas variable. With that we are taking the control over this canvas which we have created in this HTML file, and we are getting that by getElementById, that is HTML5 method. So getElementById, with the JavaScript we are taking the control up into this variable, and then we are getting the context, and with this context we are drawing this circle. We are drawing the arc with this 50 50. So see here, it is starting from here 50 50, and the 40 is the radius of the circle. We can increase and see the size of the circle will be increasing. Now I'm giving the 50, and let's see here, it is increasing. So this way we can draw a circle. In the next lecture I'll be trying to fill the color into this circle, and we'll try to move from one point to another point. So see you in the next lecture.